Looking at a test report can often be overwhelming. Let's take a closer look to see how near-end crosstalk, or next, is reported. Our next measurement is made in both directions, from the main and from the smart remote. We're going to concentrate on the main end. This 3.8, or 3.8 dB, is our margin, sometimes referred to as headroom. What's confusing is we also see main on the right-hand side here again, and this time the margin is 11.7 dB. How can that be? We have 3.8 and 11.7. Which one's right? Well, the 3.8 dB on the left is the worst case margin. That's the closest point to the limit line. The 11.7 dB on the right is the absolute worst case value. Let me see if I can explain how those two values are derived. We'll start by looking at the worst case value. First, we'll make the measurement. Now we'll locate the absolute worst value of near-end crosstalk. Up here is good. Down here is bad. And we'll note that value, 38.4 dB. Then we'll put in our test limit and report the gap, or our margin, which in this case is 11.7 dB. But if you look carefully, that's not the closest point to the limit line. The closest point to the limit line is actually around about 150 MHz. Let's do this again, but this time we're going to do worst case margin. First, we'll put the limit line in. Then we'll make the crosstalk measurement. Now we'll find the closest point to the limit line and note the near-end crosstalk value of 42.2 dB. Now we'll report the gap, or the margin, between our near-end crosstalk value and the limit line, a much smaller 3.8 dB. So you will always end up with two margin values. One is the worst case margin and worst case value. The standards require us to report both worst case margin and worst case value. How did we get into this confusing situation? It goes all the way back to 1995. Back then, there was actually not a requirement to report both, or one or the other. It was pretty much left open to the test equipment manufacturer. So this became quite controversial, because if you only reported the worst case value, the margin typically looked quite good. If you reported the worst case margin, then the margin didn't look so good. So the argument goes is, well, I'm only ever interested in the absolute worst value, I mean, which is the higher frequency stuff. However, the danger in doing that, as you can see in this example here, is your trace can actually be closer to the limit line than you think. The solution? Report both.